Let's have a quick demo of this lab 02. In lab 02, we are going to use Windows command to do storage management. Here are the steps. We will create a virtual disk. On this virtual disk, create two partitions or volumes. One assign a letter X, the other one assign a letter Y. Then we create a set of folders and the files. Okay, now let's first complete two steps. I would like to open a terminal window here, the PowerShell window here. CMD, so go to the command prompt. I save everything inside the lab 02 folder. Okay, now I'm under this lab 02 folder, under this ITS 372. So I work from here with disk part. Disk part. You can type help to see the commands supported by disk part. Yeah, there are lots of commands. There are two ways we can create disk part. Through GUI or through this disk part. First, I demonstrate you using GUI to create a virtual disk. Here, inside your disk management, you can create a virtual disk under this action menu. Here you select a file name for this virtual disk. And on lab 02, let's say require a test. And the size is at 1 GB. And fixed size, click OK. Okay, you see it show up here. And it's attached automatically, not initialized. If we don't want to attach it, you can check here. Currently it looks like it's not attached. If we want to attach it, click OK. Oh, it's already attached. So when it's attached, it will show up here. Now, if I don't want to attach it, we have offline detach, which means currently it's online. So we detach this one. Click OK. Now it's gone. This is the first way we can use GUI to create a virtual disk and attach. But the attach is attached automatically. So I would like to delete this one because I want to create virtual disk inside a disk port. I'll create vdisk command. You can type help create vdisk. Here, create vdisk, specify the file name, specify the max. Maximum size by default is a megabyte. You can check the readme and set up some authentication user access rights. And give all right access to all authenticated users. You specify this code. What's the name of this one? SDDL strings. So here it's not easy to see it. I would like to open it on our browser. Here you can see disk port. I suggest you go through this menu, for example, list available objects, disk volume partition vdisk, determine focus, which means your the object you currently working on. And the subcommands supported by the disk port. So you can click one to find the usage. For example, that create a VDisk. Create VDisk is not show up here. You check this create. We can right click, open a new link. Here we see the create partition, create audio. You use like this way, but we didn't see a create VDisk here. So we can Google search create VDisk. Here Microsoft, you see how to use the create VDisk, the syntax, parameters, examples, but it says they no longer updating this content regularly. You check this example. Here is easier to see than here. Okay, now let's create a virtual disk type fixed maximum 1024 megabytes. Create VDisk file equals, we want to save it here, and its name, let's call it xy.vhd, and its type is fixed, not a dynamic, and the maximum equals 1000 megabytes, or 1024 megabytes, this is 1 gigabytes. Press enter. Here you see the virtual disk is created for us. Now we need to select this virtual disk as it discussed here. We need a working object, determine the focus. Here we use a list disk. You can see currently we have only one disk. That's the drive C on my computer. So we use select VDisk. Now let's see how to use it. Help select VDisk. We need to specify the disk file. So select VDisk followed by the file name. Ctrl-C, paste here, xy.vhd. Okay, now it's successfully selected. If we use list disk again, now we see disk 0, that virtual disk is not online, so we can use attach vdisk, just like you insert a disk in side of your machine. Attach this VDisk. And now it's successfully attached. List this disk again. Use your arrow key, bring it up. Here now you see disk 1 is our virtual disk. It's 1024 megabytes. The virtual disk. Okay, it's selected and attached. We can use a detail to show some information. Detail disk, so it work on the selected disk. The disk 1, our virtual disk. You can see the status is online. Location path is says unavailable. This is weird. Right? We specified our location path, and we also see read only node, which means it's not a read only. So we can right create volume on it, but here it says no, there are no volumes. Now we want to create a partition. So here you come here, see create partition, primary partition, EFI partition, and so on. Let's create a primary partition. Yeah, you check an example, create partition primary size, specify the size. So we can create partition primary size equals 512 megabytes. You follow this part. The requirement, we create attach 1 gigabyte virtual disk, create 2 partitions, each 512 megabytes. So you didn't say the partition type, we use this popular primary type. So we press enter. It says succeeded in creating the specified partition. You will use a list disk to check it. Now we have partition, we can use a list partition. Right, you see we have one partition, partition 1. And we inside this list disk, we see our free space is only left 510 megabytes. Because 512 megabytes is allocated to this partition 1, is offset from 64 kilobytes. For all this stuff, if you want to learn detail, you can check the manual, and we will learn them in IDS 452, digital forensics. Learn further details. Here we just create 2 partitions and create files folders. If we list volume, you can see that is volume 3. It says raw 512 megabytes, and volume 0 is D, the CD-ROM. Volume 2 is C, my CGL. It's like inside my computer. You would choose the computer to have a look, you see that is a C and a D drive here. The volume 0 is D, volume 2 is C, volume 1 is invisible here, is a system write scale partition. Volume 3 is the partition we just created. Okay, we want to create one more partition. Create partition primary. Now if we don't specify the size, it will use up all those free space. So press enter. Okay, it's successfully created. So now we use a list partition. You can see partition 2 is 510 megabytes. And we have partition 1, 512 megabytes. So here it says each of 512 megabytes. It cannot be done because we need some extra information to save at the beginning of this disk. That's why you see here is the offset. It's not start from the beginning of this disk, start from here. Now we have 2 partitions. We want to format one partition as FAT32, the other as NTFS. So we can come back to the online help to find the format. Here you can see this format commands. The format commands, here is a syntax. We would like to see an example. If you want to specify all those parameters, please read the document carefully. Here I just want to do a quick format. Here these are the examples, but we only have 3 examples. Let's type here help format to have a look. Okay, you can see the example here, format FS, the file system label. And quicker, do you want to compress the disk? Compress is only supported by NTFS, not supported by FAT32. You have learned this in IDS 135. Currently, I select the partition 2. Let's select partition 1. So we select partition. Let's list the partition first. I think it starts from 0. List partition. Okay, it starts from 1. Then we select partition 2. Now we select partition 1. It says partition 1 now is now selected. You can list the partition, see the store mode to partition 1, means this partition 1 is selected. Now we can use that format. FS file system, the first one, let's use NTFS. It's a case insensitive. NTFS, so upcase, lowercase does not matter. And the label, we want to say this is NTFS. Yeah, and we want to do a quick format. Now you see the computer quickly. Here we use list partition again. List partition, the partition does not show the file system. How do we see the file system? Here we can use this one, display information about the current file system. So we can use this file systems. But we select the partition, we need to select volume as it says on the volume of the volume. So let's list volume. We have volume 3, volume 4, volume 3 is currently selected. And you see the label is NTFS, the file system NTFS, size 512 megabytes. Here we type file system, file systems. It show up the file system. From the file system NTFS allocation unit size, you can find all this information in this format command. For example, that unit size here, what does it mean? The allocation unit size, choose the default. This one is the default, it's a 4 kilobyte. Okay, this size show up here. Here it says file systems support for formatting to this type of file systems. We can format that partition into NTFS, FAT, FAT32, and REFS. So for further details, please read this online help. Now we format this one. Into NTFS, we use a list volume to see it. Now we want to select partition 2 or volume 4. So we can use select volume 4 while you select partition 2. Now volume 4 is the selected volume. Now again we want to format it, but this time we want to format into a FAT32. You can type file system to see what types of file systems it support. I think it support as what we just saw. FAT32, its label, let's change it. FAT32, and format quickly. Okay, it's done. We list volume again. Now you see our FAT32. Volume 4, file system label size. Okay, we complete this part. Now we want to assign letter, job letter, X to the FAT32 partition, Y to the NTFS. So assign job letter, can go through this command. Here is assign. Assign job letter or mount point to the volume with focus, or with that star, with focus. here check example, the sign letter equals something. Currently, because I select this file set two, and file set two, we want to assign letter X. So we type assign X. Okay, we need check this assign let equals X. Okay, assign let equal X. Okay, so assign a letter. Here you see my drive C and drive D. These are the letter LTR. But for my entity, these two, volume 3 and 4, there is no letter. We can list the volume again to have a look. Now you see the X, the letter is assigned to this file 32. For the NTFS, we need to select the volume first. We can also select partition. Partition 1, we know partition 1 is volume 3. Select partition, I have a typo there. Partition 1. Okay, now it just says it's partition 1 is selected. You can use a list of volume to verify your selection. Here you see volume 3 is selected. This store is here. Now we can format it. Format. We not assign the letter. Assign letter. If we don't use the equal sign, let's see whether it works. Assign letter Y. And also you see without the equal, it also worked. We can use a list volume. Now you see X for a FAT32, Y for NTFS. Okay, we complete this part. Now we come to the step 2. Before we go to step 2, we can have a look inside our computer. You can see we have a drive X here, FAT32, and have a drive here, NTFS. Now you wonder why the free space is so small, and also this total size is also smaller than the size list here, and you will learn why in IDS 452. And you can see for NTFS, this file system, it needs more extra information than this file 32 or this file system. Here is used. And now we can exit this disk part. Leaving disk part, okay, come back to our lab 02. In step 2, we want to create, copy, explore folders and files. So go to partition X to create these folders. Here we cd partition X to switch it right away. We need a switch forward slash d. Here you see now I come to the root folder OX, the Java X. Here it asks us to create these folders. Top folder, can you see? Make a dir, paste here. You can always check here. Now you see how Hawaii show up here. Then under this top folder, we create four subfolders. Here, not four, actually, not four, it's five subfolders. Let's copy it. CD Hawaii. As enter, now we are inside Hawaii. Make dir, paste this folder name here, but we need to delete the comma. Oops, Okay, we can create these file folders in one command line. Now it's created, you can go inside, have a look, they are all here. To see this hierarchy, you can also use the tree command. Here you type tree, I think let's use a clear the screen. Now I type tree dot means the calendar folder. So you can see it's a hierarchy clearly. The folder hierarchy. Next step, create a set of empty files under these folders. The first one is a readme under the top Hawaii. Then h case 1 to h case 9, totally 9 files under the subfolder Hawaii. Okay, how could we create a set of folders? We can use a for loop here. You open this for loop to see how to use it. Some example how to use it. And we will learn in detail next week. Here, I just show you a quick demo. Click this readme. We create the readme and the Hawaii folder, the top Hawaii folder. How do you create it? You can use echo. If we want to echo something, if we type just the echo, you will get echo is on. So if we type echo, single quote, quote them together, you'll see double single quote. So it looks like an echo. Nothing. It's not easy. It cannot be done. We use the type. Type means output the contents from files. There is a special device called null, which means nothing. If we type null, you see nothing sharp. So we can use type null. Use redirection. To input nothing into this readme, so the readme will be an empty file. You can see it will show up here with 0 bytes. Here, readme, and its size is 0 byte. Next, we create h case and subfolder Hawaii. So we need to go to subfolder for Hawaii first. Here we are under the subfolder Hawaii. Now I want to show you use for loop. Over slash L means we use a list of number and iteration variable. You can use I. Then the range is from 1 to 9 and the step is 1. So 1 to 9 step by 1. So we need to say the iterator variable in this range, then do something, just like the command show up here. For the iterator variable in the set, do something, you can put a command over there. Now, because we want to create those files, so we use type null. The h case, now I want to replace the h case 1 as h case person I, then it will become h case 1, 2, 3, 4 until 9. So this way how to create a series of files. You press enter, you can see the h case 1 and h case 9. You can go to this subfolder to have a look. Here, h case 1 to h case 9. Right, now the second one and Honolulu subfolder use this whole case. We can copy it. We need to cd, go to the parent folder, then go to that Honolulu folder. Okay, you see we are on the Honolulu folder. Then we can bring up this for loop and change this file as ho case percent i is from 1 to 5. So we only need to change the last number to 5, 1 to 5. You can have a look over here on the Lulu. Currently it's empty. Now we press enter. You see whole case 1 to whole case 5 is created. Now we go to color wall to create H case 11 to H case 16. So we cd, go to parent file folder, then go to color wall and bring up that for loop. The file name called H case. Again, we need to replace that one with this iterate variable. And it's from 11, k case 11 to k case 16. Again, you can keep an eye. Press enter. You see the created. Okay, now go to cd, go to parent folder, core, I'm on the core, then we use that putting up, and the core we putting up this for loop, here the for loop. Now, its name called this call case 23 to 28. Oops, now it looks like let's make it longer so we can see it. Here we change the number, use this iterator variable. Is from 23 to 28 call case and call. We press enter. You can see they are created here. Now for this MAUI, we want to create mk02date, DAT. So we first go to the MAUI folder. Then we bring up the for loop. We change this number here, percent i. But it says from 02 to 07. So we need to add 0 here. Then we change this one to 7. And this one is 2, from 2 to 7. You may be tempted to use from 02 start by 1 to 07 and remove this 0. That will not work. You can try it by yourself. Okay, let's keep an eye. Press enter, can see this M case from 02 to 07. Next step, change the extension of DAT to TXT under this MAUI. Here, we can use the rename command. We are still under MAUI. So you can use a wildcard dat to txt. Keep an eye over there. Press enter. Right, you see the extension is changed from dat to txt. Now copy all folders and files from partition X to partition Y except these files. So it was one command line how globally do this. But before that, I suggest you to use the tree command to show the hierarchy of all the folders you created, all the folders and files you created under this FAT32 drive, the X drive. You can use the tree command, show all files. Under this X drive, press enter, so you can see it's a hierarchy. Compare your output with these statements, the requirement. README and the top Hawaii, and HKS 129 and Hawaii, and whole case 1 to whole case file. And Honolulu, K case 11 to K case 16, and Kalawao, Kau case 23 to 28, and Kauai, Maui, M case 02 to 07, since we changed the DAT to TXT in this step, so it's TXT. So it looks good. The wildfire is cracked. Now we want to copy all the folder files from partition X to partition Y, except these files. So there are two powerful commands called xcopy and robocopy. You can open this command, and this copy command is a basic copy command. This basic copy command can use the copy files from source to destination, and you can read this by yourself. Here I want to show you this drop copy and this X copy. For example, the X copy, you can copy everything here. For example, copy all the files and subfolders, include empty substructures from A to B. So this is what we need, right? From copy everything from here, from X to Y, except these three files, all folders and files. Now, how do we accept those files? Oops, this X copy here. So we need this part, change A to X, B to Y. To accept some files, you can scroll down to have a look which one you can use. There's no example to demonstrate, but when you check its statements, see there is a says exclude file name 1, file name 2, file name 3. Specify a list of files. At least one file must be specified, and each file will contain search strings with each string on a separate line in the file, and when any of the strings match any part of the absolute path of the file to be copied, that file will be excluded from being copied. So this sounds satisfy our requirement. So we don't want to copy these three files. So we can go to Y drive. Now I'm on the Y drive and I create a file. Let's call it no copy. This time we can use echo this file name, copy it, paste here, to a file say no copy. Here you can keep an eye on RY. Y currently nothing. Now I create a no copy. And you see no copy is created here. You want to see its contents, just right click. Open with, for example, Notepad or your code here. Educate file.txt.txt is inside. We want to use command line to complete all the job. Suddenly you can use that Notepad editor to put the other two files names inside. Okay, we'll use echo and this file, copy it, paste here. Now this time we use a double logic. This means append. We append the output of the next echo to the contents of this no copy file. Again, the last file name is mks04.txt. Copy it, paste here. Okay, you can use the type no copy to see its contents. Here you see its contents, three file names. Or you just open with our code. You see that three are file names we don't want to copy. Okay, now we can use the command xcopy. Xcopy from x to y with everything. You can check what the meaning of this switch is. X here. This E means copy all subfolders even if they are empty. So we don't need as it says. You copy directory and subdirectory unless they are empty. If they are empty, they will not be copied. So we use this E. This E is more inclusive than that S. So we don't need that S. You may check the example what switch is it specified. Here the user has a E. So I think it's redundant. We only need this E. It says use E with the S and T command line options. So it just copy all subfolders, even if they are empty, but it need to be used with this one. So my bad. Yes. Now we specify that exclude here, exclude followed by our file name no copy. Please pay attention, I run this command just under this Y drive, which means in the root of this Y drive. Okay, now we press enter. You can see the folders and files that are copied, and you can verify those three excluded files are not copied. The hk file here, you see 426, that file is gone, and the k case 13 is gone, right? And the mall case m case 04 is gone. So we did this step. And now for the review questions. Use copy, x copy, lob copy to construct command lines to achieve the following goals and show your command lines work as expected. See, first let's see whether we can achieve this stuff with these commands. With these tasks. These tasks should be able to complete with a batch script, and we will learn next week. This week we just want to use the single command line to see whether we can complete each task. Here is the result. we just did. The first one, it says show your message before copying each file. So which means show message, show prompt. We can try to see this X copy whether it shows us prompt. Your Ctrl F, prompt. So we can go through all these prompts to see what it says. Here is the first prompt. Prompt you to confirm whether you want to create each destination file. Okay, this looks nice. This is what we need, right? The prompt confirm whether we want to create each destination file. Now, how do we show this one? We can do it like this. Here, we go to Hawaii. Now we can create a folder. Let's call make dir destination or target. Let's create a target. Then we want to copy every file from this Maui. You can choose any subfolder from this list. I just chose the Maui. I want to copy every file and the Maui to this target folder. Here we have this target folder is empty. So we can use this X copy with this switch. So X copy, we want to copy everything and the Maui. How do we specify everything? You can use star. Star means everything. We just want to show the each destination file, right? Here. Before you copy each file, this is one demonstration. Certainly, you can also specify that /s and /e if we have subfolder inside this Maui. Suppose you want to copy everything on the Maui, including subfolders. If we put those /s, /e, but here is okay. Now, in this way, we don't need to use this store. Right? Copy everything from Maui to target. And we want to show the prompt for each file. You will want to create the target file. Let's see whether it worked. Press enter. You'll see, do you want to copy this one? Type Y, yes. Do you want to copy this one? Yes. File, yes. 6, yes. 07, yes. File is copied. So now you can... how could we compare the target folder and the Maui folder that contains the same files? And we will learn later that is a file comparison command called FC. If we want to compare a folder to see whether that FC can, whether it can be used for compare folder or not, we go to the command. Windows command. It was the F. You can see FC. FC file compare. Here it compare two files, set of files, and displays the difference between them. So we can use this one to compare two set of files. So how could we do that? You can read these parameters carefully. We want to go to an example to have a look. Here, example, FC, compare them as ASCII comparison. Here, you make a binary comparison. We want to see a compare sets of files. Not one by one. Here, compare every bad file in the current direct with this file, new dot bat. Okay, it's one file with a set, another set of file. We cannot, if we want to create, compare here, compare each batch file in the root folder with the same name. Okay, this is what we want. This is what we want. So we can use FC to compare everything under the MAUI folder and FC under the target folder. Here you see it says comparing files, no difference, no difference, no difference. So we are done this part. Now, question 2, update destination file, only copy files nearer from the source to destination. So if you check the date here, it's 6:50, the target. Here is 6:33 p.m. So all these files in MAUI are older than the files in this 6:33. The time they are the same. Right? 6:33. So the timestamp they are the same. Now we want to update destination file only copy files nearer from the source to the destination. So how do we make it newer? For example, this MAUI, we can modify it. This date modified will be updated. For let's check this last one. We open it and type something. I'm newer. And save it, Ctrl S. Now you see it's modified date is updated. So this is a newer. Now if we want to only copy that newer file, how do we do that? So we go to the X copy. Now we search newer. Newer. Here there is a newer. Copy source files changed on or after the specified date only. If we specify that, if we do not include this date temp, it will copy all source files that are newer than existing destination files. And this command line allows you to update the files, have changed. Update files, have changed. So how about those not changed files? And copy files from source that exist on destination only. So we can also use this U, use this D, and any others we want to use. Display source and destination file names while copying is also good. So we can use the X copy from the MAUI to target. We want to specify these options D, so we only copy those newer here only. Copy source file changed on or after specified date only. Otherwise, it will copy all source files that are newer, so only newer. Let's see whether that's true. Anyway, we also want a prompt. If we have a prompt, that would be nice. I think let's also supply S and E. We want to have some prompt. Prompt here again. Let's switch up to see create prompt. Whether you want to create each destination files, we suppose those identical file will not copy, only copy the newer file. So let's go to the go through these options. Upload existing destination file, this dash y. So we can use a dash y dash minus y to prompt whether we want to overwrite existing destination file. Here, this good example K and P copy this customer directory or subtract to the this directory. Return read-only attributes and be prompt when a new file is created. It uses P for prompt and use I, this I for what? So we need to go up. That I here is this one. If source is a directory. Okay, we don't use that. Alright, now let's execute this one to see whether it copy all or just the newer one. Here you see the only say this is 07. And do you want to overwrite? Okay, yes. Okay, just only one file copied. So this command satisfies our requirement, this one. Only copy the file newer from the source to the destination. Now question 3. Copy a folder and all its subfolders, no matter a subfolder is empty or not. So this one is that these two parameters, S and E, right? We just did that. So we don't need to try it again. If you want to specify it, you specify like this, copy SE from the source to the destination. This means copy a folder and all its subfolders. Now, question 4, copy only hidden files. Let's check question file first. Problem to confirm that you want to overwrite an existing destination file. So here with this this one minus y, it will give us the prompt whether we want to overwrite it or not. Right. So we can let's do file first. So in this case we can delete two files from this target and only leave three. So these three, when we copy it, let's see whether it will give us a prompt. So we use this command again. Right now we don't need this D, we want to copy all those files. So press enter. You see it says MK0302 and 03 is copied to the target. Just show up. Now for those existing files, 05, 06, and 07, it gives us a hint, a prompt. So you can type a yes or then it will overwrite. You type a yes. Oops, just type a Y. Not type a yes. Right? 05, 06, it still ask me to press a letter Y, yes. Now 07, press Y, yes, done. Files copied. And the three existing file prompt me whether to overwrite them. Okay, question file is done. Now, for question 4, copy only hidden files. Okay, let's remove everything in this talked folder. And in this Hawaii folder, or let's still use the Maui folder. How do we see the attributes? We know there is an attribute command, right? Attribute command, Maui. We want to show everything. Show all the files. And you see A, they're all archive. Means all archive. You can check this attribute, how to use it. So the attribute command plus minus plus means we set that attribute. Minus means we remove that attribute. R, what does R mean? R means read only. A means archive here. This A is archive. S, system file. H, hidden file. Now it says only hidden files. So we can change some files to hidden files, for example. Let's just change one. So in this way we can control the behavior. Maui come inside, then we use attribute plus H. Let's change the 03. M case 03. You can use attribute to show these files. Right now you see 03 is archive and hidden. And you see it's hidden from here. You cannot see that 03 now. Again, we want to also set one file with more attributes, for example, system and hidden, even read only. So we use attribute plus hidden plus system. This time we change that 0 file, mcase 0 file .txt. And use attribute, bring up to see. Now you see this one, 0 file is hidden, and system is also hidden from here. You can add more other attributes, for example, read only. Let's change this to 06. Attribute plus hidden plus read only to that M case 06. Oh, 06 is hidden and read only, and you see it's hidden now. As we discussed, we want to copy those files with only hidden here. Only hidden. Here, these files, we want to use one only hidden. Let's change the last one to only hidden. Attribute minus A plus H M case 07. Right now, 07 is only hidden, and also you see it's hidden from here. Only 02 show up. You can use attribute to have a look. Now, this 07 is only hidden. And the question asks us, copy only hidden files. I think this is a little bit ambiguous. Only hidden. Do you think all these are hidden files? Right? Yeah, certainly there are hidden files. If it says hidden only, copy hidden only files. So hidden only, we can consider this one is hidden only. Since it's confusing, we need to solve these two cases. let's solve the hidden only case first, which means we only copy this one to the target, but we don't copy others. So could we do that? You can check the xcopy command, find the attribute, here go up, these are the attribute, copy files and return the read only attributes on the destination file and so on. Copy files with hidden and system file attributes. By default, it does not copy hidden or system file. So if we use xcopy to copy to the target, you will see we only copy this M02, but not the hidden system files. We can have a try. Xcopy SE, we copy everything, and we want a prompt from MAUI. Oops, let's yeah, it's okay. We can use a xcopy SEP, and now this time we use dot means current folder to the target folder. The target folder is in the MAUI's parent folder. So target, we copy it like this, and we can open that target to have a look. Here is target. So we press enter. Do you want to copy this one? Yes. It says only one file is copied, which means only that 02. Right. Now, if we want to copy hidden system files, we can specify this edge. How about this A? This A says have the archive attribute set. This archive. And this M, unlike A, it will turn off archive attributes in the file that are specified in the source. So these are not what we want. Here you can check this. It looks like none of these will complete our target. So next we want to copy. If we use this edge, it will copy hidden and system files. So we can add an edge permit. Now press enter. It says copy 02. 02 is already there. It's okay. If we use no, it's still there. Now 03. We know 03 is hidden, right? Based on here, 03, 5, 6, 7, they are all hidden. So type yes, 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 yes. Right now you see this parameter, edge parameter. It will copy all these hidden files and system files. But it does not show up there. How could you see it in this view? Manual, you can turn on those visibility. Yeah, show height. Here, hidden items. Now you see they all show up. But there's three zero file, not show up. What's that zero file? Zero file is a system and hidden. So it looks system is also hidden. You see this icon is lighter than this icon, these hidden files, so we know they are hidden files. We still want to turn on that system files, but here we didn't see. So go to the options, change folder and search options. The view, scroll down, you see those hide stuff, empty drive, hide protected operating system files. So I think this is the system for us. If we show it, yes, apply. Okay, you see it show up over there. Right, this is a zero file. It show up there, the hidden and the system files. Now it looks like if we want to copy hidden only, which means only this 07, it looks like this X copy cannot accomplish our wish. Let's have a look on this job copy attribute here. It specifies which file property to copy. Now it copies the file attributes. Which file attributes to copy? Okay, here the file attributes, the file property, not file attributes, file property, data attributes, timestamp, ownership, and so on. We want to find that specific attribute here. Add the specific attribute to copy the files. This is not what we want. We add this stuff to the target file during the copying process. Here, remove the specified attributes from the copied files. Okay, these are not what we want. Copy files with only files for which the occur attribute is set. So this is similar to that X copy. The M. Nope, this is also not what we want here. Include only files for which any of the specified attributes are set. Now, if you have edge, then it will be copied, right? I don't want other attributes here. We have exclude files for which any of the specified attributes are set. So this looks good. I want to exclude everything else, but include only hidden. So it looks like this is what we want. So let's have a try. Global copy. Now this time we use IA H, include H only, and exclude or other options or other attributes. Other attributes are a S C N E T O except H. Now other options. Is all other options similar to X copy, for example S, E, H, those things. We can have a try, right? To have a look. And also you can see this lob copy is more fine grained. You can specify more details, exclude changed files, exclude newer files, old files, and so on. So we, and even the file size, other options. So this is a very powerful command. You can read through this one to find other options. Here we want to see whether we have those options. Here you see this option similar to the X copy. How about that P prompt? Prompt. No prompt. So that's no prompt. We use S and E. Now this time let's delete all these files in the target because we want to demonstrate. Now here it says zero file is a system file. It's okay, we want to delete it because we create this one. And you also see system file is protected by Windows. This is nice. Now we specified those stuff and we want to copy from the current folder everything to the target. we use this relative path. Here we want to check, double check, copy subdirectories, okay, now let's press enter. There's no prompt, this is what missed from that X copy, right? We look for a prompt, there's no prompt, hint, no hint, no prompt, message. You can read slow to see whether you find a prompt. Now I press enter to have a look. Double copy, so it says it does not recognize this command. Double copy, okay. Robo copy, robust. Maybe it means robust. Robust copy. Now robo copy. Okay, we succeeded this target. Only MK07 is copied. Here you can see there is a report of the result. Robust, yeah, it's a robust file copy for Windows. And you see this report. From the source to this destination, we want to copy everything, all the files and subfolders, but because we specify these attributes, and only one file satisfied those criteria here, mismatched, failed, extra, skipped, total, directory, and files, total file, copied one, skipped four. Okay, this is nice. We complete all these review questions. To learn more, please read the all the commands online document.